Joining us on eMind Rocks now, it's the man with the muscles of steel and the heart of gold. It's Sonu Sood, the savior. Sonu, welcome to eMind Rocks, first of all.
Yeah, thank you so much, Shirang. It's always a pleasure connecting with you, brother. Thank you so much.
Asha, firstly, your energy hasn't dipped. And I mean, it's remarkable what you've done. People have been just showering love for you, and they've sort of, you know, encouraged you each step of the way. Talk to me about your life after March 2020. How has it changed?
You know, I felt that I found a purpose. You know, I came to Mumbai to become an actor. Then the whole COVID thing happened, and when everyone was clueless, including me, what to do and how to, how your day is going to pass, you know, then suddenly the whole movement of migrants, that everyone got disturbed when they saw on television. So I thought, you know, this is one thing which is not going to happen, and I'm not going to sit at home and let it happen. So that's the time I went out, and I think God chose me as a catalyst to make things happen. And finally, I'm sitting in front of you, and I'm a happy man today.
So tell me some of the stories from, you know, the past few months. All of the people that you met, how tiring was it? Did you ever get frustrated? How challenging was it?
I was always on my toes, you know. We could hardly sleep, almost 20 to 22 hours on our toes, on the phone, coordinating with people. There's a very close friend of mine, her name is Neeti Goel. We were distributing food to almost 50,000 people in Mumbai every single day. And that's the first time we met these migrants who were planning to go to Karnataka. And they were planning to go, on foot. So we stopped them, and I followed the whole procedure of getting permissions done. And that's the first lot of 350 students that went to Karnataka by buses that I had arranged. And that was a turning point, and I realized that this is not just the story of 350 people, but about the millions who are walking on the roads in different parts of the country. And I have to get connected with everyone, and I have to give my best to help them go back to their homes. And this is how I connected with almost 8 lakh people in that 1 week.
Wow. And can you share some personal stories that remain with you? Some of the interactions that maybe made you feel very emotional, or some of the, you know, the typical sort of challenging situations which you had to face?
There were many of them. Sushant, I remember there was a lot of 177 girls, 167 girls and around 10 boys who were from Kendrapada Jagai in Orissa, and they were stuck in a stitching factory in Ernakulam near Cochin, and they didn't have food to eat. They were in a really bad shape, and somehow they had sent me a message on my Twitter handle that, you know, if you can rescue us. So then I started the whole process of getting them out, and I realized, because all the Kerala was in complete lockdown, Orissa and all the states that were connected with that, and there was no means to get them back to their home. So then I got these airports operated open for 2 hours, the Cochin airport and the Bhubaneswar airport, and we flew them, these 177 people, and you know, they were so happy. And I remember 3 a.m. in the night, you know, I was talking to them, coordinating, making them sit in the buses. The flight took off, 10:30, landed in Bhubaneswar. And now they're back reunited with the families. And yesterday I get a call from one of them that, you know, sir, I have a plumbing and welding workshop, and I want to name that Sonu Sood Welding Shop. Can I do that? So I laughed. I said, okay, man, you can do that. And today he sends me a picture of his shop with, you know, my picture. It said Sonu Sood Welding Shop. So I said, now I have a welding shop in Odisha. Wow. Also, so if anyone wants to come, please come. So I think all these small memories are very special. And there's a lady in Darbhanga who named his son after me, Sonu Sood. And I asked her, I said, you know, you are Srivastav. And how Sonu Sood, you know, he's a Punjabi. Sood is a Punjabi. They said, no, now he's Sonu Sood Srivastav. And there are going to be many more Sonu Soods in Bihar and UP. So I think all these moments were very, very special part of my life. They'll always remain one.
And now you're writing a book on these experiences. Is that correct?
Yes. You know, my mom always used to tell me, always write those special moments that happen in your life. She was a professor, Professor Saroj Sood, and I still have her diary and the whatever notes she wrote during her college days, when she was a student and when she became a mother. So those are very special memories that she said, you know, all these rare moments in life should be on paper. And then I thought, you know, I have so many stories now. I have extended families in parts of Uttarakhand, Orissa, Bihar, UP, Assam. So why not put them all together? And, you know, everyone has experienced this lockdown and everyone has gone through these tough times. So why not put those things together? And I'm sure there'll be many interesting stories to share. And maybe in years to come, people will get to know all these people who suffered in different parts of the country and how they reached back to their homes and the challenges that we faced bringing back them to their home state. So I think those things I wanted to pen down. So that's why I thought of writing the book.
You have helped so many people, and every Indian in the country, abroad, everywhere, even foreign nationals, you know, they have appreciated you. And as I said, showered so much love for you. But this whole endeavor of yours was also given a political color. How did you handle that? We saw you visiting the chief minister at that time. Were you taken aback?
I remember, Sushant, it was afternoon around 10:30, 11 when I got to know about this article written by Mr. Sanjay Rao. And on that particular day, there was a movement of almost 6,500 to 7,000 migrants to UP and Bihar. And it was very tied up, you know, putting things together, arranging food, their travel, their small nitty-gritty things. And, you know, they called, I said, okay, let it be, you know, that's someone's, an individual's opinion. Why to, you know, give so much of importance now? Because, you know, we have important things to do. And then suddenly every channel was talking about it, every news platform was talking about it. And then they said, you know, I think you need to clear out the differences if you have any. I said, I don't have any differences. My priority is to send those people back home. And that's what I'm doing. And I did that, you know, after being those 6,500, 7,000, 8,000 people. There's a very close friend of mine who's again from Congress. His name is Mr. Aslam Sheikh. I know him since 20 years. And he said, Sonu, you know, I think it's always better to, you know, sit over a cup of coffee and, you know, clear those differences if anyone has. And people should know about it because you have been doing work religiously without any intention. So I think people get, people should know about it. So we went, we, Udhavji, Aditya, me, Mr. Aslam Sheikh, we all sat over a cup of coffee and we and he appreciated my work. He, Udhavji, said, you know, you've done a great job. And if you need any kind of help from us, we are there for you. And I think they were very sweet. And I think that encourages you more to work harder. And you know that you are on some right footsteps.